Prior to the Bassmaster Classic, I made a brief visit to Columbia, South Carolina, and was able to spend a day on the lower end of Lake Murray. Hello, everyone. I'm Kim Stricker, and welcome to another Hook and Look Splash, a splash of fishing information from an underwater point of view. Taking into consideration the recent rise in water temperature, I was hopeful that the bass had begun their migration shallow. Nonetheless, after a couple hours of working the banks and the backs of coves, I determined that wasn't the case. I then moved deeper and got a welcome sign while casting a longtime favorite on a main lake point. That's a Yamamoto Hula grub. That is a deadly finesse type jig. Catches those. Heck yeah. These fish haven't really moved in yet. The water temperature is 57, 58. And this one's out on a point, so I'm gonna fish the points a little harder. But yeah, good deal. I'll let him go. That fish came on a point in about 10 feet of water, yet it was directly in front of this dock. Seeing there's some fish out here in front of the docks, there ought to be some on this dock. Let it go to the bottom, and then I'm shaking it on slack line. It looks like it's moving a great distance, but it isn't. It's just kind of quivering on the bottom. Then it'll make a little bit of a hop. There we go. Ooh, yeah. There he. There he, that little hula grub. Now he came out in front of that dock. Now we're starting to get somewhere. You start putting the pieces together. Ugh, but yeah. Not the biggest fish, but the day is still early. There we go. Ooh, that's a better fish. Get out of there, get out of there. It's a little better fish. It's not as big as I was hoping it was, but again, a nice fish. Gobbling up the hula grub. That is one of my faves from way back, especially with smallmouth. But as you can see, it works darn well with largemouth. It's watermelon red, and I'm using a 3/8 ounce ball jig. Good deal. The hula grub is packaged in a plastic box, basically, that keeps it from getting crushed and, you know, protects the integrity of the tails and such. You want to pull the tails loose when you first take them out of the package. And then I'm just using a 3/8 ounce jig head and a Texas rigging it with a jig. Bringing it through, turning it around. Then I put a little dab of super glue on it. And then bring it through and then skin hook it. Just like that. Skipping is the best presentation to penetrate the complexity of the dock pilings. Furthermore, I recommend you use an abrasion resistant fishing line like Seaguar Abrazex. It was crazy. I continued to catch one after another off this dock, and they were all pretty much clones. Question was, just how many fish were under there, and were there any bigger ones? Although I did have some scuba tanks aboard, I didn't bring the rest of my dive gear. So, to satisfy my curiosity, I proceeded to inspect the dock the easy way with my Aqua-Vu camera.
Wow. That tells the story, huh? Oh yeah, they're loaded on this dock. That is so awesome. So awesome. They all seem to be about the same size. I'm not seeing any big females or anything. But it shows how they hold on that dock. And this is how I study the fish. If I can't scuba dive, I'm dropping an Aqua-Vu in there to, you know, fine tune the presentation. Also let you know how many are actually there. I'm gonna change positions. Let's move out in front of the dock here. Let's see if I see anything out straight out front. That trolling fin keeps that camera going straight. Yeah, this water is clear enough to where those fish that I caught in front of it could very well have come from underneath the dock, because they'd see it that far away.
This is the deeper end of the dock. Now let's reposition the boat and inspect the dock closer to the bank.
Look what I see. What is that over there? Those crappie? Oh man, there's fish all over this dock. I'm seeing bass and crappie.
For the exception of being positioned on the end of a main lake point, I was unable to determine any other explanation as to why the fish stacked up on this particular dock. There was no indication of an abundance of forage present that would possibly draw the fish here. It just appeared they were using this dock to stage prior to moving in the coves to spawn.
Look at those beauties. But no giants, just all clones like what I've been catching. But it shows you how they'll stack up on a dock.
I would not have known any of those details without surveying underwater with my Aqua-Vu camera. I'd only be guessing. Not only is seeing believing, but seeing is learning and validating. A little further off this dock, I noticed the tip of a planted cane pile protruding out of the water. Another prime target for my Hula grub.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, that's a better fish. Right out of that cane pile. Get back here. Don't you go over to that cane pile. Easy, easy, easy. Easy, easy. That's a better one. That's a better one for sure. But they're eating that Hula grub. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Right there and stuck them good. Watermelon, red flake. But look at that nice Lake Murray bass. Came right off that cane pile right there. Sitting in about 8-10 foot of water. Good deal. And loving it, loving it, loving it.
If you're interested in picking up some Hula grubs, I'd appreciate it if you'd order them from the link below the video description. Every little bit helps, and it keeps me doing what I like to do. In turn, I'll share what I learn with you. Thanks for watching.